As we wandered through the night, we held on to each other in fright. Both of us carried on our back few belongings packed in a sack. While the whips snapped all around, only I heard her crying sound. I held her gently in my arm to protect her from any harm. We both lived through a violent time, prisoners guiltless of any crime. Even during the greatest despair, I always knew that she was there. We calmed and soothed each other. She was a child, I was a mother. I felt safe when she was near. Losing her became my greatest fear.
My name is Inge. I am a doll. I was made in Germany. I love when children are happy and their lives are good. This is all a doll really wishes for. And though our expressions never change, when children suffer or are mistreated, dolls hurt inside too. No child should be mistreated or have to go hungry. Dolls believe every child is a shining star deserving of love and the opportunities to grow and succeed in life. Unfortunately, many children are not treated like the beautiful stars they are. I don't know why. There was a time in the 1930s and 1940s when life was especially cruel for Jewish children. That's when the Nazis ruled Germany and most of Europe. They and their accomplices killed 1.5 million Jewish children. And the children who did manage to survive suffered from starvation and disease. One of those children who made it out alive from that time was a girl with the same name as me, Inge. Inge Auerbacher. She had a doll that she named Marlene, who looked exactly like me. This is the story of how together they escaped death and destruction. This is Inge in Germany today. And this is her doll, Marlene. Marlene now lives at the United States Holocaust Museum in Washington, D.C. She is one of the most unique items remaining from the World War II era. A few years ago, Inge and I went back to the places of her and Marlene's childhood to recall the horrible events of that time. Why should we remember these dreadful events? The death of one innocent child is a catastrophe. The loss of such numbers is unimaginable. Their silent voices must be heard. Maybe by remembering, a child will be saved from unnecessary suffering today. Inge Auerbacher was born to a Jewish family on December 31, 1934, in Kippenheim, a village in southern Germany. Her father had his own textile business and they lived comfortably. Jewish families had lived in Kippenheim for at least 200 years. Inge was the last Jewish child born there.
I'm in front of the grave of my paternal grandparents, Lena and Solomon Auerbacher, and I never knew them, but I do honor them.